remember watching a video a few years ago from The Verge titled "The Chat App Slack is Killing Email," which as it turned out was a pretty genius introduction. The premise was that Slack was better than email, that it made more sense for groups to collaborate through a smarter chat than a separate string of emails. I jumped on the service immediately. I love the idea. The whole concept of a group chat to get things done doesn't just apply to companies. I mean, if you're in college, if you're in school, this is definitely useful. Sadly, I don't think I use Slack for more than a month. It turns out that Slack is no better than mainstream services like WhatsApp. It's a chat that sure can organize your files and has good search and helps you collaborate on specific topics with ease. But guys, so can WhatsApp, so can Telegram. Create a group chat, use search, manage your files. There wasn't really something special about Slack for it to require me to install a separate app. And then there's the concept of productivity. See, I come from the days of Microsoft Outlook, so for me it's not just about replacing email. I need a replacement for my task manager, my calendar, and these weren't really services that Slack provided. So we've been looking here at Pocketnow for a good alternative that integrates more than just email. And as it turns out, we've landed on a service called Brief that nails some key essentials really well. I'm Jaime Rivera with Pocketnow, and let me tell you more about it. In a nutshell, Brief is a chat service for teams with a lightweight integrated task manager. And I know, by now some of you are asking yourself, why should you care? You don't call the shots in your company for what messaging service is used. Let me start this video by telling you what I like about Brief the most, which is actually answering that premise. See, first of all, a team can be any kind of team. It doesn't have to be a company. It can be your immediate family or a common interest group, which I belong to a few, like my running group. I recommend it more for groups with a purpose, given all the tools that are included. Second is the problem with all the alternatives. Sure, I can create group chats within WhatsApp, Facebook Messenger, or Telegram, but the biggest problem is that when I'm using these services, other people that are not within my group can see me online. And I hate it when people assume that just because you're online, you're open to a chat. I know, some people are not just as busy as you are or I am, so I love the whole concept of having a group chat that's not public, that people can't see that I'm available because if I'm in the service, it's because I'm not. Third is the experience of using Brief. I think it's very well thought out. Creating an account is free, and like with other services, you need your phone number to create an account. You can then invite others through their phone numbers or whichever username they've picked whenever they created their account. The experience begins in the dashboard, and this is full of hubs. Think of hubs more like specific topics, and you can create subchats for each of these. Each hub also allows you to create tasks. So handling a topic is not just about talking about it, you can use specific messages to create a task. And this is really what makes Brief stand apart. Task management for me is crucial. You can schedule them, and as opposed to calendar appointments where you don't really know if something has been completed or not, you can follow up on tasks because they force you to check them off. You can prioritize tasks and also create subtasks, making this more of a project management tool, even if at a very basic level. And to serve the major selling point of Slack, yes, each hub has a file management section that also filters links and media. And then the cherry topper is the option for video and audio calls through Zoom, which for us remote teams is quite useful. So think of a scenario where you're in college, for example, you've brainstormed over good ideas over the group chat, and then you've come up with some really good ones, but you don't want to forget them, so you create tasks for them, you schedule them, you assign them to team members so that everybody knows what they have to do, and then you just follow up through the hub to know what has been completed and what hasn't. And then if you ever need to discuss more in depth, you can also just have a video chat with your team to follow up. And then other cool things about the service are that you have a dark mode option for the user interface. It's platform agnostic, meaning you can use it on your browser on your computer or on iOS and Android through their respective applications. Now, obviously, there's no such thing as a perfect product, and there are a couple of things that I wish Brief did or had. The first one is I really wish that it had an iPad app. At the time of making this video, there isn't any, and sure, you can use the browser, but notifications become pretty much inexistent unless you install the iPhone application, and we know how cumbersome that experience can be of having an iPhone app run on an iPad. If you're using devices like the Pixel Slate, which runs Chrome OS, the Android application does work just fine, so you won't have any problems there. The second is voice memos. I know that this doesn't really apply to many people, but in our case, if we're in a trade show and we're commuting from point A to point B and we're carrying all our camera gear and we're dragging it across Las Vegas, for example, I really want to be able to not forget the idea that just came to my brain, and all I want to do is send a voice memo to the team, which you can currently do with WhatsApp and Telegram. Sadly, that doesn't work here, though neither did it with Slack. And then third, I really wish that it had calendar integration. Like, for example, for it to integrate with Google Calendar particularly, because it's a real mess to have different applications with different services. And for example, the biggest problem with Brief is it doesn't really have those tasks sync with anything. So this could lead for you to overcommit to certain things because you don't have visibility of whatever other commitments you have on other applications. I feel that that is definitely something crucial for these tasks to sync with something and for your calendar information to also sync back with Brief. That would be fantastic. To conclude, I think it's very important to clarify that Brief is a relatively new service, so sure, I do have things that I'm mixed about, but it's software. I feel that it can get ironed out over time. We've been using Brief for the past 2 months, and I don't think we're going back. As opposed to competing services that focus on team collaboration, Brief is free and provides some crucial advantages. Again, file management and team chats aren't really enough to get work done. Task integration is genius, and this is pretty much the only service we found that blends the best of both worlds. Let me know what you think about Brief in the comments down below. Do you like the idea? Do you think that there are other things that it should be able to do? And while you're at it, make sure you follow us on social media. Subscribe to both our channels, English and Spanish, for more videos like this one. You can also follow us on social medias. Our extended coverage happens on Instagram. And follow me on my personal handles to see what I do with these phones in my free time. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw. I'm Jaime Rivera. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you on the next one.